In Australia, they both develop simultaneously, HIA and what we call EFIA, equity-focused HIA. And there was money available from the Commonwealth government to do innovation, and different groups applied, one to apply to do HIA and we applied to do equity-focused HIA. Because our concern was that often policies unwittingly disadvantage some groups of people. For example, there was an idea for child development that they would work with childcare centres to improve nutrition of children in childcare. So their idea was that after work, they would talk to parents as they came to pick up their children about nutrition. Now, on one level, that was a silly idea because if you've ever had to come after work to pick up a child from a childcare centre, the last thing you want is to have someone give you a little healthy talk on what you should be feeding them. And the other issue was, who are the children who don't go to childcare centres? And they may be the children whose parents don't work, or single parents, or parents who can't afford to send them. So our concern was that there was an equity implication. So although the basic policy of access to childcare was a good one, an unintended consequence was that there were particular groups who were missing out. So that the main difference that we thought was that to look at policies to see if people were unwittingly disadvantage some groups of people over other groups of people. And so that's how we developed this equity-focused approach. And what it means, the difference between that and HIA, is that at every step in the process, you ask the question, what is the equity implication? So in the screening and scoping reports, the last thing you would put in them is what are the potential equity implications? And it's imagining. A lot of it is about imagining what might be the unintended consequences, or to look at a similar policy in another state or another topic and to see what you can learn from them about what was an unintended consequence of what they were doing. So that at the end of every step you would ask, what are the equity implications? And we would try and think outside the box, because we all know that people might look at gender and socioeconomic status and ethnic background and whether they're rural or urban. But we tried, or have still tried, to look a little bit deeper than that to say, are there particular groups within rural areas who might be at most at risk? And so that may well be people who are living on isolated properties, who haven't got good access to any sort of transport except their own cars. What we found over the years is that people who are like me coming in, we would often forget, even though we knew we should do it, we would forget to do it. But I find with the next generation of staff that we've got, they are much more thorough in making sure that we do look at the equity implications of what's happening in those things. And as far as, are there tools? Yes, there's many tools. There's one called HIAT, I think it's called, Health Impact Assessment Tool, or Health Inequality Assessment Tool. And it does a similar thing, but in a slightly different way, because it's not related to a health impact assessment. It's just looking at any policy or plan and saying, how could you look at this and see if there's going to be unintended equity implications. I think if you Google equity tools, that you'll come up with more. There's a lot of them. I think it's really finding one that suits the way you work. But at its simplest form, I think it's just at every step, ask the question, what are the unintended equity implications? Because we're assuming that nobody starts out with the idea they're going to cause more inequity in what they do.